Are you looking to be the fabled hero of your FNM? Do you want to demolish your opponents in the next PTQ? Check out channelfireball.com strategy content. We've got articles and videos from Hall of Fame players like Luis Scott Vargas, Paolo Vitor Damo de Rosa, and Ben Stark, as well as other incredible pros. While we can't teach you how to make puns like LSV, we're sure you'll learn a thing or two.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Back for another Cube Draft here on Channel Fireball, Holiday Cube, etc. First pack is not too strong. The cards that jump out to me as things I would be interested in are Gristlebrand, extremely powerful card worth building around, a lot of different ways to build around him. Vampiric Tutor, just because it's so generic and so good, and if you're playing black, you will probably have that in your deck at the end of the day. And then Natural Order is also pretty strong at getting out large green creatures, which I also enjoy. I think I'm going to go with the Gristlebrand, though. I could see taking Forbid if you want to be, like, super controlling or something like that, but I could see also taking, like, Hellspark Elemental and being aggressive red or Figure Destiny. But I'm just going to go with the Sweet card. We'll see where that goes. Sweet card leads into probably Unburial Rites. It means if we get Gifts, that works. This is one of the stronger reanimation spells. This pack's loaded. Treachery is really strong. Metalworker's really strong. Jit's obviously really strong. I think I'm just going with Unburial Rites, though. A lot of good cards I could wheel here, too. Got a little bit of a combo going. Unburial Rites I like a lot because Gifts Ungiven is usually pretty undervalued because it's difficult to set up things with it. Ooh, we're definitely going to take... Could see taking Dark Ritual, but I think Force Will is just stronger in general. Usually you're blue-black if you're a reanimator. And there's nothing else of a third color that I would want here anyway. I would take Dark Ritual second out of that pack. A single Gifts Ungiven allows you to combo Unburial Rites with it and then get any large creature out. You do it at the end step, you gift so they don't see it coming, and then you untap and you Unburial Rites. Works pretty damn well with Gristlebrand, but it also works, you know, with plenty of Iona's, a common one. Elish Norn's pretty common. That combo sees play in things like Modern, so certainly strong enough in Cube. All right, that's a good sign. Frantic Search is pretty good in Reanimator. It's the one deck, well, that and Storm are the two decks where I actually would want to play it. Glenelg Archmage is also really strong as a Slaughter Pact. But we're just going to go in on the Reanimator plan, because why the heck not? All right, what do we have here? We have Gravecrawler, which is mildly interesting in this sort of strategy. Sphinx is kind of decent. I think I'm going to take the Chantry over Inquisition. Inquisition's decent, but you can end up with a lot of cards that function that way. Chantry allows us to do a couple things. On the draw, you can play it as a land that will let you discard something like Gristlebrand. It also color fixes and lets us splash on Barrier Rites a little bit easier. And I think Bounce Lands are just overall really, really strong in the cube. Plenty of cards here that we would consider playing if they wield, but nothing too high of a priority. I think I'm going to take Toxic Deluge here over Watergrave and Forcespike. We just picked up Mana Fixing, so I don't feel as inclined to take this. And Toxic Deluge, I think, is pretty important for unfair decks to beat the good draws out of fair decks. Ooh, there's a Corpse Dance. Definitely taking that. Corpse Dance is really, really strong. Bloodgift Demon is whatever. I would actually take Revelark, I think, before Bloodgift Demon. Intuition's pretty good. There's a Duress and an Intuition. Intuition, you can get two large creatures and Unburial Rites, and it does work. You could end up with a large creature in your hand, but it does work for the combo, so I'm going to go ahead and take it. Alright, Forbid actually wheeled, which is kind of sweet. All the red cards wheeled, as expected. But Forbid is actually pretty good in Reanimator, because it slows down the game and gives you a discard outlet. I don't know if we'll end up playing it in our main deck, but it's certainly a completely reasonable card. Definitely taking Mystical Tutor here. Pretty good in Reanimator. Although Bloodstain Mire is also pretty good. We knew we were going to get something good out of that pack. So we have the makings of a really good Reanimator list already. We have two reanimation spells, multiple discard outlets from Frantic Search, Intuition, Forbid. I'm just going to take the Mana Fixing here. We have one large fatty. We have a tutor for all those things I named. So our deck's coming out together. Got a little bit of Mana Fixing. Breeding Pool is probably not going to do much for us, but you never know. All right, pick up a Wooded Foothill. It's definitely the choice over Boonstator or Gargadon. Gargadon's reasonable to reanimate, but fetch lands are just so good. If we pick up enough duels, it'll be very good. Brain Freeze, I'm not going to pass. I'm just going to take Broodmate Dragon on the off chance that we play it. I guess there's a bigger chance that we play this. This is a better card to reanimate, so. Sure. We have multiple green fixers already, so maybe if we end up playing Broodmate Dragon, we can actually cast them. I don't know. I guess Wooded Foothills right now does work with Blooded Breeding Pool because it finds it as a forest. So if we pick up like a Steam Vents or something. Yeah, we know. Alright, we have a Thoughtseize. It's pretty good. Phyrexian Metamorph and Aetherling are also both pretty good. I honestly think it's just Thoughtseize. On that wheel, one of these two lands. Thoughtseize is really strong in reanimation. It's just a good precursor to set everything up. Una's Prowler is reasonable, but we already have some discard outlets. Gilded Lotus is reasonable just to cast our stuff, but I think Thoughtseize is more important because we already have a really good foundation. And then these large creatures are going to be pretty easy to come by. And I think we'll wheel one of the two, or three fixtures, actually. So, yeah. I think Thoughtseize is definitely the pick there. We passed up on a Duress and we passed up on Inquisition, but Thoughtseize is just the best, so might as well take it. Show and Tell, definitely our choice here. That gives us another discard or another reanimation spell that we don't ever have to reanimate. So that's really strong. So our decks, now we're just looking for fatties and then things that synergize well. Basically it. And we're already doing pretty well on that home front. All right, what do we have here? We have a Dream Halls. It does something. Another duel. I think I'll just take an Impulse. I could take another duel. I don't really want to take Dream Halls. Although it does kind of work with Show and Tell and stuff. Another dual land's not the great. I'm just taking Impulse. If that had been a black-blue duel, I would have definitely taken it, but it was a blue-white one, which is not the best. We could take Swords here. We could take him. Him works really well with Thoughtseize. And preferably, we're going to be barely splashing white, and we're going to use Counter Magic and a little bit of black removal to deal with guys. So I think I'm going to take the him here and be pretty happy with it. Still looking for large creatures, but that's fine. Alright. We got a Frost Titan. That's certainly a large creature. Blue-black dual land, a removal spell, draw card or thingy, major bobber. Is this good enough to reanimate? I don't think so. I think I just want this. This card is really strong. Buried Alive will probably wheel, and if not, Agony Warp will. Maybe this guy's worth taking here. I don't think so, but maybe. Like, this guy's not really good as a reanimation spell. This thing is. But I think Baleful Strix is a little bit better. So I took it. Definitely taking Underground Sea over. I could see taking this. We have enough discard. But it's not going to do much in our deck. And Venser, while fine, it's just going to be worse than just having a fixer. A good fixer. The best fixer. Void Mage Prodigy is reasonable. This card's also reasonable. Grim Monolith is pretty strong, though. I think I'm just going to take that. Two mana spells that let you cast six mana spells in the next turn are pretty strong. So, like, this makes me want to have Frost Titan more in my deck. And that type of card, at least. Right now, I have a Broodmate Dragon that's filling that role, but that's not as reasonable. I know I'm passing up on a lot of these large guys, but they always come. They always wheel, and if they don't wheel, you only need, like if we get one boar, we're pretty happy, for example. The ones that don't wheel are like the Ulamogs and the Emrakuls, and we're not even necessarily looking for those. We have a Show and Tell, so we'll play them, but we're definitely wanting guys that could be reanimated or put in play that way. All right, a bunch of stuff here we don't really want, so we're going to take a Steam Vents because of the interaction with Wooded Foothills I mentioned earlier, and plus we have Broodmate Dragon, so I think we should, might as well. Other thing we could take is Arid Mesa, but I don't want Tendrils, and Time Twister's not very good in this type of deck usually because you're trying to fill up the graveyard, so that's my reasoning. Alright, so we did wheel the Basilica as expected after taking the Thoughtseize, so I'm pretty happy with that. It's a bounce land. So we got pretty good mana fixing. So now we got good mana fixing, we got some good disruption. We picked up Thoughtseize and him and Baleful Strix, all pretty solid. Baleful Strix is kind of nice with like things like Corpse Stance and stuff too, which is pretty sweet. So it has some other uses. So we picked up a lot of filler cards and a lot of mana fixing, so we just basically got to get this end, and we'll devote our next pack doing that. We might even pick up like a Frost Titan or still this pack.
That kind of card's usually not beloved by people, but Aetherling didn't wheel. Aetherling's significantly more powerful than Frostwyvern, though. Alright, we wheeled a Scrubland, which is obviously very sweet in terms of fixing. We didn't wheel the Gothic Shrine, but we wheeled the Scrubland. I'll take it. Alright, we get another fixer, I guess. That'll be all the white we're going to need. Again, I could take Dream Halls, but we don't even, we're plenty good on that department, I think. Sure. It's the card I hate playing against the most there. Alright, we picked up a Fixer and Agony Warp. I think we got plenty of fixing at this point. I picked up so much that I'm going to take the Agony Warp in case we run into any of those fair decks I was talking about. Whoa, Kobe! But yeah, we picked up Scrubland and Underground Sea and Attakar Wastes and... Like, basically, we don't have a ton of blue-black fixtures. We only have a couple. But since those are going to be our two main colors, it's not even that necessary. And we're not going to have to run any white lands that aren't dual lands.